Susan Bonner has more from Washington. So, Susan, what effect would delivery of this system have if it proves to be true?
Well, the timing of these comments by Assad, the way he has chosen to make them, and what he is actually saying can be seen as highly provocative. It's as though Assad is trying to strengthen his position, dig in before this conference, which he said he is still willing to attend or have someone from his regime attend. He essentially said that he has taken delivery from the Russians of this advanced surface-to-air missile system. Now, this is a highly effective weapon that could complicate, for example, something like a no-fly zone, which has been much discussed as a possible Western intervention option if it comes to that. Countries like the United States, Britain, Canada have reportedly considered this kind of an option. But with Assad having these advanced missiles that could shoot, that could respond in any way to any aircraft, it would certainly complicate things. The fact that Assad has given this interview to a Hezbollah controlled station is another provocation to the West. The West, countries like the United States, Canada, Britain, see Hezbollah as a terrorist organization and have strongly condemned Hezbollah's increased role in the Syrian war. So Assad is, well, he says, I'm going to go to this conference and we are prepared to talk about a political solution to the war. He's also acting in a provocative way, and that's got to be troubling for the countries that are trying to calibrate how they respond to this and continue to plan for the conference that they hope will bring an end to the fighting in Syria.
This is south of Norman, Oklahoma. Now, if you see the funnel cloud there, it's quite a spectacular sight. But I would not live there for all the tea in China. These are two different views.
System can become operational within 6 months to a year after construction begins.